Towards the latest movie reviews and PR activities, subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to People's Voice Season 4 in collaboration with teachers. I hope you all are doing great as always. A teacher is like candles who spend whole life in giving lights to many students. And today's our guest has similar traits, who is young, lively, and lighten up the room wherever she goes with her multifaceted personality. I am excited to chat with her to know a bit more about teaching world, her experience. But before that, let's chat with each other till she comes in the chat room. Hey Raji, Karthik, how you all doing? If you have any question, comments, as I always say, do put your comments in the comment box. If time permits, we'll definitely get back to your question. And with that, I can see our guest is in the room. Let me just invite her. Hey Neema, hey Amol, hey Atik. How you all doing? How you have started your new year? It's been almost 5 days that we are in 2021. Hey Gloria, here she is.
Hey. Hi Naseema, how are you? Hi guys, hi everyone.
I'm doing very well. How about you?
Yeah, I'm doing good. Thanks for having me here today.
It's a pleasure. Gloria, we are just on time. Let's begin with a short introduction of yours. Let me just introduce you to all our viewers. Good?
Yeah.
Gloria Alfonso Raju, a classroom teacher for Indian English Academic School, Don Bosco, Kuwait. An independent, self-reliant, and ambitious lady. Almost 10 years of teaching experience for grades 1 to 5. Gloria loves to explore different aspects of teaching. Therefore, she had been a part of various well-reputed institutions in India, be it school day schools, residential schools, or school for underprivileged. She aspired to be someone that will make a change in the lives of people around her. With that, a warm welcome to you on People's Voice, Gloria.
Thank you, Naseema. Thank you once again.
Gloria, as I mentioned in my introduction that you are a multifaceted personality, then what made you choose teaching field as your profession?
Well, to answer that question, teaching is your answer there itself, because being a multifaceted, as you said, so yeah, of course, teaching is the best way I think I can have all the roles to play every single day in the lives of my students, in my own life. And being a teacher, most of the time, everyone thinks it's very conservative and, you know, teachers are like seen as only in the classroom, only doing certain things. But for me, it was not that. For me, it was more like, you know, a better chance to do everything that I wanted to do, basically. Because teaching, I would work in school from morning to afternoon, and then that would give me a whole day to also explore different things and to bring different things to the classroom as well. And yeah, school is full of activities. What more do I want?
That's excellent. You are, as I mentioned, multifaceted personality and the vibrant, the new way to teach to students by doing other things and bring the different aspect to the teaching world. Very, very nicely said, I must say.
Thank you.
Gloria, you are a young lady and almost 10 years experience you already have in this beautiful teaching world. I'm sure you're the right person to ask to how easy and how tough it is to be in this profession.
Well, easy? No way. It is one heck of a job, because, you know, you have to be on your feet and your mind has to keep working. The most thing is that your mind has to always keep running, you know, because kids can be really tedious at times, you know, because the more you enjoy their company, the more you are in for challenges and surprises every single day. They'll come up to you with all kinds of abrupt ideas, all kinds of, you know, things, because they're so much into the social media, so much into the outside explorance and all that. So when they come to you, they have all the information and knowledge, and they come up with all kinds of questions. So if you are supposedly in front of them and you're like, oh, I cannot answer that, or I don't know what you're talking about, so that really doesn't work like that. So, you know, so if you want to be on their top list, you have to work day in and day out. So I would say teacher's job is definitely very challenging. Very.
Absolutely. I think for kids, Google is their teacher. They need to have answer for everything, whatever their question will be. So I can understand it's a tough task to be a teacher. And we all look up to teachers. For us, the inspiration comes from teacher. But I wonder, during the tough times, especially during the challenging phase, who inspires you, Gloria, to stand tall and overcome those challenges?
The strongest personality in my life has always been my mother, my mom. She's been in this same field for the last 30 plus years, and, you know, she's got a vast experience. So, you know, her experience of the olden school, the old school ways, and compiled with the new school times, it really makes things very easy for me at times. You know, I keep looking into the new spots, like, okay, to find something better. But then, you know, when I have a word with her, I do find a lot of ideas that I can actually put in, because, you know, this is all the retro world right now. So people are going backwards. You know, the more we're coming forward, we want to adapt the things which we all had earlier. So, yeah, I would say definitely I have had a lot of inspirations in life. But with teaching, it was my mom, the first inspiration. And then I actually took teaching very seriously and learned the aspect of teaching from my mentor, Sister Clarice, who is, you know, the principal of Sacred Hearts TTI in Bangalore. So there I was introduced to what is actual teaching. And, you know, I was taught that teaching cannot stop you and keep you within the classroom. So that's when I started, you know, exploring that creative side of mine. And, you know, I was always encouraged to bring new things and to, yeah, and I've been, from then on, I've been always dancing on different tunes.
So. I think for most of us, our inspiration is our mom, that the way they handle the toughest tasks and make it look so easier with their perseverance, attitude, and the hard work. I'm sure your mom is a one strong lady who inspire you. And then you become such an inspirational teacher for all of us and for your student.
So true.
Now we discuss about the challenging task, but teacher is such a beautiful job. I realize, especially since I started this series of People's Voice, that it's such a grateful job. Even when you are teaching or you are at the receiving end, this profession is so freaking grateful and full of, you know, who are learning from you, express the gratitude towards teachers. So it is tough, but I'm sure there must be some best part, some beautiful part of it. If I ask you what it will be, then what it is for you being a teacher?
For me, my kids are the most beautiful part of my teaching. Because, you know, the more I say that they make it a tough job for me, they are the ones who make it very easy for me as well. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I might go in with all the stress, and, you know, when they are around you, even if you want to keep that stern face, that's highly impossible. And, you know, so being in the lower age criteria, that also gives me that freedom that, you know, I can jump, run, talk, whatever with them. And, you know, that's actually the most fun part of mine. And so the most valuable time that I spent is with my kids, because, you know, every single day they teach me something new. Every single day they show me something I'm not doing right. And, you know, they always encourage me to, in their own way, to, you know, to develop and to form a better personality. That's how it is. So being from all these years, I think almost everything that I've learned is through a hands-on experience. Nothing through the books has ever, you know, been able to answer questions that kids have put forward. Yes. So the most valuable part of teaching, I would say, is the time that you spend with your kids.
Oh, true, true, true. And I believe all my guests have the same answer. The best part of being a teacher is to interact with kids. And during this tough time, I'm sure you all must be missing so much the physical classroom teaching, which is the essence of being a teacher, interacting with the students.
Very true.
Talking about COVID-19, describe a typical teacher day before COVID, how your day looks like from the beginning till the end as a teacher.
Well, being a teacher, the day itself starts with you starting to think. The moment you wake up, the first thing that comes to your mind is, oh, what's my first class today on the timetable? So where am I going first? So then according to that, you start building up your mindset for the day. And it's not, I would definitely say a teacher's day is not limited to that one single day, because to present that one single day, we would need preparation of a whole week, basically. And the pre-COVID time, but yeah, of course, it is very convenient for us when we are in classroom situations to connect with our kids. And kids are in front of us, we can still deal with them, and we can understand if there's some issue going on or anything like that. But now it's very tough at this possible time. Right now it's very, very difficult to to connect that way with your kids, though we are trying our best. So I would describe a teacher's day as on the run. The whole day is on the run from one class to the other, and before you are having your first free period, you already have a pile of books waiting for you for correction. Once you're done with that, you're off to a sip of tea or coffee, and by then the bell rings, and then you're again on the race for the whole day. So the whole day just vanishes in front of your eyes in a in just a snap. That's it.
Your day sounds like a juggling of balls, doing one thing, going to another, going to another. Like there is no break except your tea break. And kudos to you and all those teacher who works round the clock, doing such a beautiful responsibility so that our future becomes bright. So yeah, congratulations for being such a wonderful teacher.
Thank you. So it says tea for teacher. We say tea with the teacher because teachers are always for the tea, always waiting for the tea break.
Yeah, true. Gloria, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I can.
Gloria, now we are in a completely virtual world, especially from last 9 months, due to the obvious reason, due to COVID-19 pandemic. What is the toughest part of giving class online?
The toughest part, as I said, when we are in a normal classroom setup, we can things that we have not prepared earlier or whatever, we can make it on spot, and kids are right in front of our eyes, so we can control them. We can make sure they are for concentrating. Even that is such a tough job of making the kids concentrate when you're teaching. And being it a home environment where most of the time parents are at work and kids are in front of the computer, my main concern is that they've been always in front of the screen, and that affects their eyes, no doubt. On top of that, above all that, the kids sit in front of the system, and it's their home after all, it's their comfort zone. So it's a the toughest part of teaching online is to get them to attend your class, to pay full attention. They are in front of the screen, but you never know what's going on, under the table, at the side, or they're just playing with a toy, or they're distracted. They suddenly put off their cameras, they're off camera, we have no idea. So it's very difficult at times to control that situation because it's an online situation. Yeah. So
True.
that's the main concern, actually.
True. I hope looking at such a scenario, I never thought of because that phase of my life is over. So yes, talking to you, I can realize how many activities must be going on the side behind the scene during the classes on. So I really hope that we get back to the physical classroom activities soon, very soon. And
Oh,
with sorry.
I bet the parents are waiting for that to happen. They give us a call every day, and they're like, "Is there any way you're starting classes? Just take them."
I'm sure. I'll keep all those parents and teachers in my prayers. It sounds so funny, but I can understand that it must be really a very hectic and a bit of a messy life during COVID.
Yes, it is.
Gloria, we are almost towards the end, but before you leave, any last thought on teaching profession?
All I would like to say is don't take teaching as just being in the classroom and you just have to keep on relating your subject matter or something like that. For me, I've always thought teaching is fun. So yeah, just take it as a funny situation. Just go with the flow, enjoy your days, and just have fun out there. There's no need to actually make it a point that, oh, only my subject is what I need to be doing. So that should be the last thing on your mind. So yeah, that's what I believe.
Very, very well said, Gloria. I thought your voice was getting disconnected. I'm not sure. Can you hear us, Gloria?
Yes, I can hear
Video
you
is.
very well. Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, all right. Very well said. I got your message, and I hope so too that all the teachers just take the teaching profession as not a duty, as not a monotonous duty, but just go with the flow, enjoy the journey. With that, thank you
Yes.
so much, Gloria, for giving your precious time for People's Voice. It was a pleasure to have you.
Thank you so much, Nasima. It was an honor to be around. Thank you so much, everyone who's watching and who's been around. Really, thank you. And have a nice evening, all of you.
You too. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye. See you.
So that was lovely Gloria, who livelily represent her profession, and in a different she has given a different perspective for teaching world. As she said, just enjoy your journey, go with the flow, do not make it a duty, robotic duty. And yes, wherever you find something extraordinary, you will find the fingerprints of a great teacher. On that note, I would like to sign off People's Voice Season 4. Take care, stay safe, stay indoor as much as you can. Bye-bye.